Hi, today review until done of this wonderful item from the flea market. I did get it from a hipster for 3 euros. We have here a fine product from China, the AM/FM table radio in nostalgic vacuum tube design, model number here, with illuminated tubes. So first, of course, you will notice there is a big fail because it does not look like a tube radio. It looks maybe a little bit like a tube amplifier, but surely not as a radio. And there is a trap, of course. So you can see we are supposed to get a fancy thing with a silver color and wood grain on the side, with three fake vacuum tubes with in plastic with very small grills inside. And other fail on the manufacturer plate here in the middle, there is something written, so I will try to zoom in for you as much as possible. Because there is a typo in this thing, we have here a premium radio and not maybe supposedly a premium radio. So it is the first big fail, well, second even. So about the trap and the features. So first the features, here is all what you get for the price. You have an AM/FM radio with built-in speaker. You have a volume knob. You have a FM antenna wire. You have a band switch and you have power supply with batteries. All this included in the box. And here at the bottom you have the different colors available. And we can see we are getting the glossy black one, but not the fancy wood grain one. Something interesting, you can note the blue one comes with blue lights in the tubes. They did not make a green one with green tubes, sadly. Other side of the box is exactly the same thing. And here we have the same stuff written in some other foreign language. Okay. So if you open the box, we can see it is pretty new in the box, in fact. At least the box design is not too bad, because you have this external layer of cardboard for protection of this delicate and precious item. We still have the original wrapping bag here. And guys, here is the precious. We are also given two user manuals in English, probably. So about these user manuals, we have your unit to operate on 6 volts DC power. In fact, the text seems quite correct about the translation. I do not see too much English in this. And no Chinese or French also. And here we have do not obstruct the venting holes. Yes, of course. Sure, such a thing must eat a lot. So, about the fails, second fail you cannot. If you compare to the box, on this thing, on this plate, we have nothing written. It is not written premium radio as expected. It is quite sad. So here we have the three fake tubes, which are made of plastic, with a little lead in the middle inside a metal grill. We have the speaker in what is supposedly the transformers of this vacuum tube amplifier. We have the antenna wire. We have which I will deploy for maximum sensitivity of the thing. We have the as expected, the volume knob with on-off switch. We have fingerprints on this plate, and we have the very sensitive and delicate tuning knob. And we are missing something, guys. Where is the band selector switch? Yes, very conveniently, it is under the device. Here, of course, we have a battery compartment with four Chinese batteries, which are not original. So, I will try to turn it on and dial into a station without music. So you can see the three tubes light up with little LEDs in the middle. I'm trying to find a station with no music. By the way, this volume knob is very bad because from here to here it is the same, it does nothing. And just here it is starting to make sound. Here is the station.
Son petit cœur brisé. En tout cas, aujourd'hui, tout va très bien pour elle. Elle est vraiment devenue la référence dans le milieu des groupies, puisque après ce
livre-là,
elle en a écrit d'autres où elle
est vibrating at this level, of course, making very bad noise. Well, at least we have some reception.
Avec son petit matériel, elle faisait des moulages. Il y a plein d'histoires.
It is working like as an auxiliary radio. In fact, it is doing the job, but of course, this station selector switch is very bad, and it is difficult to dial into an emitter. As you can see, really what you could expect for a cheap radio. In AM, I think we have nothing left except strange noise. Okay, so let's crack this figure open and see what we get inside. I think we can expect one very crappy circuit board with in a cardboard or biscuit like brownish material. So just four screws to undo here. There is a little arrow here indicating the screws you are supposed to remove, as Sony does. We have a design patent number. Yes, you need to patent such a nice design. We have the manufacturer plate, the dealer here. And it complies with FCC rules, with FCC and CE marks, which seems to be a legit CE, not a China export mark. So if we remove these crappy screws, of course, we get exactly what we can expect. A brown circuit board. One IC doing all the job. Some old glue everywhere. The volume knob with switch. Very cheap potentiometer and a very cheap variable capacitor for tuning. Old glue, AM antenna with what seems to be yes, two wires. I do not know if it is how they expect soldering wires together, because look, not sure what they did here, but it seems they are. Now we have two wires in here connected at the same spot, in fact. Okay. And interestingly enough, we have some kind of insulation sheet here made of with some plastic foil to insulate the second PCB at the bottom, which is just holding the LEDs. So if I pull on these buttons, I should be able to... we have more screws. So pulling on these buttons will allow to remove the PCB, like so. Here is the solder job, guys. Quite crappy as expected. Big blob of hot glue solder here, hot glue here. And the second PCB, which is holding the three LEDs and the metal grills around the LEDs with this plastic sheet. Loudspeaker here, held in place with some hot glue, and it looks like we have a second part in here for the upper transformer block of the supposed vacuum tube amplifier. Yes, like so, in fact. It will separate like so. Okay. So about this fake vacuum tubes, they are just plastic tubes held in place by this PCB with the three LEDs soldered on it. And it is pretty much everything. Something I did just notice. We have some loose bits in here, it seems. We have some rubber sticky pieces, which are not sticky anymore. Not sure where they are coming from. And you can change this plate for personalizing to your brand. Obviously, here it is a no-name radio. Okay, so I do not know if I will spend time to reassemble this thing or if I will just put everything in the bin. For now, thanks for watching. Bye bye.